Hello friends, welcome to my channel CBC Tutorials. In this video I'll explain you the exercise 1.6. So let's start. Now before we start this exercise, this is one important formula and this we are going to use all through the exercise. So this formula, you can see it says the number of elements of X union Y is equal to the number of elements of X plus the number of elements of Y minus the number of elements of X intersection Y. Now over here, this set XY is just given for representation. It can be either set A or B, C or D, or any other set. So this is a formula which you're going to use all through the exercise. So let's start. Now the first question says, if X and Y are two sets such that number of elements of X is equal to 17, that of Y is 23, and X union Y is 38, that is the number of elements of X union Y is 38, we need to find the number of elements of X intersection Y. Okay, so this is what is given to us. Now I just showed you the formula. Okay, X union number of elements of X union Y is equal to number of elements of X plus number of elements of Y minus number of elements of X intersection Y. So you just have to put the values into this formula. Okay, you need to put the values that is given to us. These three values are given to us and we have to find X intersection Y. That is the number of elements of X intersection Y. And when you put the values and when you substitute and further, you get that X intersection Y is 2. Okay, the next one, you see they say if X and Y are two sets such that X union Y has 18 elements, X has 8 elements and Y has 15, then how many elements does X intersection Y have? So first you write or whatever is given to you, okay, whatever elements are given to you, number of elements, then write the formula that X union Y is equal to number of elements of X plus Y minus number of elements of X intersection Y. And then you just substitute the values that are given to you, like 18 should be over here. Then 18 is equal to 8 plus 15 minus number of elements of X intersection Y. And when you solve for the answer, you get the answer as 5. So that is X intersection Y will be 5. The next question, you see, they have not given you directly whether it's intersection or it's union. Now from this question, you need to identify whether they have whether the given number is for intersection or union. So let's read the question. And it says that in a group of 400 people, 250 can speak Hindi and 200 can speak English. Now how many people can speak both Hindi and English? Now they say you that in a group of 400 people. Now when they say a group of 400 people, it means they're talking about union. So this number is the union. Okay, number of elements of union of two sets. And of that, 250 can speak Hindi, 200 can speak English. They have asked how many people can speak both Hindi and English. That means we need to find the intersection. Because people who can speak both Hindi and English, that is, they have a common thing in them. That is, we need to find the intersection. So let us consider that H is the set of people who speak Hindi and capital E is the set of people who speak English. Now from this we know that since they said group of people, so H union E, okay, H is for Hindi and E is for English. So H union E will be 400. Then they say 250 people can speak Hindi. Okay, so number of people who speak Hindi is 250 and number of people who speak English is 200. Okay, then they have asked you to find how many people are there who can speak both the languages. That is, we need to find the intersection. Okay, because they have asked you both the languages, it means the common thing. So again, we put the same formula. Instead of X and Y, we have put here H and E. So there's nothing different. The same formula is there, where number of elements of H union E will be equal to number of elements of H plus number of elements of E minus number of elements of H intersection E. Now we have the values. On substituting the values and on further calculation, we get our answer as 50. Okay, so that is the intersection, that is H intersection E, that is the final answer is 50 people can speak both Hindi as well as English. So let's see the next question. Now they say if S and T are two sets such that S has 21 elements, T has 32 elements and S intersection T has 11, then how many elements does S union T have? So this is a very direct question. You know they have given you the values over here. they have asked you to find S, U, N, T. Three values are given to you over here. You need to write the formula and put the values in that. So first, you make a list of all the values that they are given to you. Number of elements of S, T and S intersection T. You need to find S, U, N, T. Put the formula. In place of X and Y, put S and T. And that's the formula. And put the values in the formula. And for the substituting, you get the answer of S union T to be 42. Okay. Now, fifth question you see, if X and Y are two sets such that X has 40 elements, X union Y has 60, and X intersection Y has 10 elements, then how many elements does Y have? Okay. Now, they have said you that X has 40 elements. They have said you what is X union Y, the number of elements of X union Y is 60 and that of X intersection Y is 10. So they've asked you to find the elements of Y. This is also a direct question. First, make a list of all the values that they have given to you. That is, these are the values they have given to you. Then write the formula. You have to find the number of elements of Y. That is, you have to find this. So you need to substitute the values and find the number of elements of Y. And basic calculation is there. And further calculation, you get the answer to be 30. So number of elements of Y is 30. Then the sixth one you see, they say in a group of 70 people, okay, group means union. When you see the word group, automatically you have to analyze that it means union. So your union is 70 people. Now out of that, 37 like coffee, 52 like tea, and each person likes at least one of the two drinks. Okay. Now, how many people like both coffee and tea? So, a small hint I would give you here is that whenever they say at least or whenever they say or, it means union. Okay? These two are keywords. Whenever they say you at least or whenever they mention you or, it means union. And whenever they mention you and or whenever they mention you both like this, how many people like both coffee and tea, it means intersection. So automatically when you see these words, you have to understand whether it's union or whether it's intersection. So what they have given to you is first, well, let us consider C be the set of people who like coffee and T be the set of people who like tea. Then they have set you in a group of 70 people. So your coffee, that is coffee and tea, that is C union T will be 70. Okay. Then they have said 37 like coffee, 52 like tea. So number of elements of C is 37 and that of T is 52. Then they have asked you how many people like both coffee and tea. Now they have said you both or and, it means intersection. Okay, so they have said you how many people like both coffee and tea, means you need to find the intersection. So you write the formula, that is number of elements of C union T is equal to number of elements of C plus number of elements of T minus number of elements of C intersection T. So on substituting the values, you need to find the value for the intersection. And when you perform the further calculations and when you get the value, the answer is 19. So there are 19 people who like both coffee and tea. Now next question you see, this is a little bit tricky. Now they have said you that in a group of 65 people, okay, so union is 65. Out of that, 40 like cricket, 10 like both cricket and tennis. They have asked you how many like tennis only and not cricket and how many like tennis. So there are two questions given to you here. First question, they ask you how many like tennis only and not cricket. So they have asked you how many like purely tennis. Now when they say over here that 40 like cricket, it means that 40 people like cricket and out of that, there might be few people who might be liking tennis as well. So when you find out the number of people who like tennis, it means that there are some people in that number of people who like cricket as well. Okay, so first you need to find how many people like tennis actually. And then out of that, how many people are there who like tennis and cricket. So let's see how to solve this. First, we'll consider C be the set of people who like cricket and T be the set of people who like tennis. Okay. Now they have given you in a group, they have given to you in a group of 65 people. So C union T, that is group means union, that is 65. Out of that, number of people who like cricket is 40. They have mentioned to you. Now out of this 40, some people might be there who might like tennis as well. Okay. But they like cricket too. So that is what it means. number of people who like cricket is 40. Then they say you 10 people like both. Okay, both means intersection. Okay, so 10 people like both cricket as well as tennis. So C intersection T will be 10. Okay, that is common thing, that is intersection. 10 people like both, so that is common thing. Now that will be your intersection. So first we will find how many people like tennis, just tennis. We are not finding how many people like tennis only. First we will find how many people like tennis. So for that we will write the formula. Okay, and on substituting the values we will get the number of people who like tennis to be 35. Now this is the answer for the number of people who like tennis. But now this 35 has those people also, it has those number of people also who like tennis as well as cricket. That is, all these 35 people like tennis, but out of these people there might be few people who might be liking cricket as well. So we need to find those people who like only tennis and not cricket as well. So first we get 35 people like tennis. Okay, now we need to find the people who like only tennis, not cricket. So for that what we do is, number of people who like only tennis is the number of people that we have got who like tennis, okay, 35, minus the number of people who like both tennis and cricket. So when you do that, 25 is the number of people who like only tennis. So what this means is that 35 were the people who liked both tennis and cricket. Out of that, who liked only tennis, and out of that there were 10 people who had a liking for cricket as well. But that doesn't mean that they don't like tennis. They like tennis as well as cricket. Okay, so that is how you find the number of people who like only tennis. For that you need to do the number of people who like tennis, that is, it means they like cricket as well, some of them, and then minus intersection, that is number of people who like both. Now when you do that you get 25. This means that 25 people are there who like purely tennis, that is only tennis, and they don't have a liking for cricket. So that is your final answer. Then the eighth one you see. In a committee, 50 people can speak French, 20 can speak Spanish, 10 can speak both Spanish and French. So how many people can speak at least one of the two languages? Okay, so they say 50 can speak French, 20 Spanish, and 10 can speak both Spanish and French. Both Spanish and French means they have given to you the value of intersection. Okay, so they have given you the value of intersection. And then they say how many people can speak at least one of the two languages. Now if you remember the hint that I gave you in my previous questions, whenever they give you at least, it means you need to find the union. Okay, this is your hint. Whenever they give you at least, or they give you or in that, or all in that, then it means you need to find the union. So here also you need to find the union. So we will write the values, that is F stands for the people who speak French and S for the people who speak Spanish. So number of people who speak French is 50, number of people who speak Spanish is 20, and there are 10 people who speak both Spanish and French. Now when we put the formula, that S union F will be equal to number of elements of S plus F minus number of elements of S intersection F. So the same formula we put over here. Then we substitute the values and we find the value of union, because they have asked you at least one of the two languages. And whenever they give you at least, it means you need to find the union. So your final answer after substituting the values will be 60. So with this we come to the end of exercise 1.6. I hope you understood my video, and if you liked it, please press the like button, and yes, don't forget to subscribe my channel CBC Tutorials.